Vincent Medjibe is measuring Gabon's trees. In hundreds of 1 hectare plots all over the country, Vincent's team from the National Parks Agency recorded height, diameter, and species of every tree, and from there calculate the biomass and the amount of carbon in each plot.
C'est vraiment avoir un le stock, c'est-à-dire la quantité de carbone que nous avons, et de faire aussi le suivi dans le temps pour voir aussi le changement en termes de la structure de la forêt et aussi le changement en termes de carbone, parce que le carbone est dynamique.
Above Vincent's team, satellites orbit. Any change spotted in Gabon's forest cover generates an immediate alert at AGEOS, the nation's Earth Observation Agency. A new track through the trees, a possible sign of logging activity, an expansion in mining, legal or illegal, all immediately recorded and investigated.
Dès que le satellite passe, fait l'acquisition d'images il y a un mois et celle d'aujourd'hui, on voit qu'il y a des changements. Tout de suite, on fait l'alerte, on fait le rapport et on va sur le terrain pour vérifier si nécessité. Mais quand on est sûr qu'il n'y a pas besoin d'aller sur le terrain, on reste rien. On envoie juste le rapport.
Gabon's forests are continuously monitored from the skies and on the ground. This is a country with a remarkable 88% forest cover and a determination to keep it that way. A system of controlled, sustainable harvesting of trees creates jobs and income while maintaining overall annual deforestation well below 0.1%, one of the lowest rates in the world.
And we believe that by raising the value of the forest, that's the best chance we have of preserving the forest. And so basically we're exploiting the forest to preserve the forest.
It is vitally important that Gabon succeeds. Gabon's forests are part of the Congo Ogwe Basin, the lungs of Africa and the world's largest carbon sink, absorbing more carbon dioxide even than the Amazon rainforest. Gabon itself is the most carbon-positive country on Earth. Its forests not only absorb all the country's own emissions, from 2010 to 2018, they also absorbed an additional 1 billion tons of CO2. Now, Gabon has joined the United Nations Red Plus initiative that aims to reduce emissions from deforestation and forest degradation and enhance forest stocks. From 2010 to 2018, Gabon has been certified as having reduced emissions or increased CO2 absorption by a further 91 million tons, equivalent to a year's emissions by the Czech Republic. As the impact of climate change becomes ever more apparent, many countries and businesses are pledging to attain carbon neutrality by 2050. Not only will they have to reduce their own emissions, but many will also need to sponsor countries like Gabon to increase CO2 absorption. They can do that by buying carbon credits. Buying Gabon's credits means not only supporting 91 million tons in reduced emissions, but also 1 billion tons of overall sequestration. In other words, for every carbon credit Gabon puts on the market, 10 additional tons of carbon were absorbed and stored in Gabon's rainforest. But the value of these forests doesn't end there. Protecting Gabon's forests means protecting some of the world's greatest biodiversity. Christened Earth's Last Eden, Gabon is home to 21 primate species, including vitally important populations of endangered gorillas and chimpanzees, and 2/3 of the world's remaining forest elephants. Forest elephants are the most visible indicator of successful forest management. While Africa's forest elephant population has dropped by 75% in the past 2 decades, Gabon's has actually increased by 58% to around 95,000 today. Purchasing credits means protecting Gabon's incredible biodiversity and ensuring the future of forest elephants. Money raised from carbon credits will go straight back to conserve Gabon's forest, boost rural livelihoods, support the Gabonese sovereign fund and reduce the national debt, and be channeled through the budget into crucial healthcare, education and climate adaptation spending.
So through that waterfall of distribution of the revenues, we're going to make sure that every single Gabonese person benefits directly from the sale of carbon credits.
Consistent political will, precise and transparent data, massive carbon sequestration, huge biodiversity benefits.
These are the best value carbon credits that you will find anywhere on the market, partly because Gabon is the most carbon positive country on Earth, so it's very difficult for any other country to do better than Gabon.
Les forêts sont très très importantes pour nous parce que je peux dire que c'est une partie de nous-mêmes. C'est une partie de nous. Si nous vivons, c'est grâce à ces forêts.